Hey, ladies and gentlemen, Jack Bradley Show. I'm coming to you from beautiful downtown Richmond, Virginia on a Thursday morning. Told you all yesterday. You didn't believe me. I got the athletic director from Virginia Union University here in the studio this morning. I have the head football coach, Coach James, here in athletic director is Coach Taylor. I have Mr. Mark James, he's the head football coach from Virginia Union University. And I know this is right off the top, I usually run my agenda, but, you know, this is sort of a special day. I've been here about 4 or 5 years. I've never had the two top athletic men in football and the AD from Virginia Union on my show. And also in the studio with me this morning is Mr. Jim Juno. And really, this all happened and started with Jim Juno when he came to Union a few years ago. He started promoting the school, and he's doing a good job at it. And Jim, if you need to move around anywhere in the studio, they film through the glass and all like that, feel free to do so. So we got the Virginia Union Panthers brain trust in the house this morning. And let me be transparent. I'm a Fayetteville State guy. Graduated from there, played football 4 years at Fayetteville State. I know where I graduated from. I know who gave me my props in life. I love them and all like that. But I also love and respect Virginia Union University, okay? It's not a loss of love. And let me check. I will fight anyone up 95 and down 95 and try to take my card, my Fayetteville State card, away from me. I'm still Fayetteville State. But I can tell you, what they're doing here and the kind of moves that they're making over Virginia Union, you got to talk about it. So we're very glad that they're here this morning. Let me do a couple of things, and we're going to come back and get the show rolling. Now, give me a chance to talk to Coach James and Coach Taylor. The athletic director is coming on first, then we're going to bring Coach James on. Give me a little bit, let me, you know, and then you can call in at 788-0990, 788-0990. My toll-free number is the same as it was yesterday, 877-953-3990. Yes, this is the Jack Gravely Show. We're live and in living color on a Thursday morning, a beautiful day in beautiful downtown Richmond, Virginia. Ryan is running the board for me this morning. Jim Juno is in the producer's chair. We have to my right, Coach Mark James. You might see him. We on camera this morning, Ryan?
Yeah.
And for those of you know, coaches and athletic director, you are on internet. We're all over the country. People can see you and all like that. And feel free to take the conversation any place you guys need to take it. The other day, Coach James, when I interviewed you from Durham, one of the callers called in, smart coach. He didn't tell you nothing. Oh, man, one of the callers called in and said, smart coach. But thank you. And the reason why I want to thank Coach James, we had Coach Kershaw from Fayetteville State. We had the new coach at Virginia State, and we had Coach James, the three of them tentative lined up for an interview. I know it was busy, and for Coach James to take time out of that schedule down there, that's his day as a coach, to call us and give us an interview and to consent to give us an interview. And I'd like to thank Reggie for help setting this up down there. And, Coach, we'd like to thank you. Let me start with the athletic director, a legend in college football, Florida A&M and other schools, and now he's at Virginia Union University as the athletic director. And I don't mean to demean him by calling him coach. He is a coach, but he is also an athletic director, an educator, a speaker, a mentor, a trainer, and a shaper of young men's lives, and that is Coach Joe Taylor, a legendary Coach Joe Taylor. I remember seeing him and reading about him, and the good story about Coach Taylor, he met me for a minute on the field when your son was playing a game down at Fayetteville State about 4 years ago. Coach Taylor met me coming out of the stands with 1,000 other folk. I met him a few minutes later. He said, yeah, I met you down at Fayetteville State. And Coach Taylor, remember poor little me? She made me bad, man. I went home and told my wife, cook me something right now. You know, but seriously, what I'm saying, the kind of man he is, and the kind of persona that he carries with him. The title and all of that is important to him, but not more important than just being a good human being. Coach Taylor, athletic director, Virginia Union University. How has it been at AD?
Well, Dad, first of all, thank you so much for having us, and this is a great opportunity. But again, you are a legend in your own rights, too, and we just appreciate
thank you.
Your support and all that you've done to affect lives in a very positive way.
Thank you very much.
Well, what I really, first of all, I was really blessed for 40 years to coach. and impact lives in a positive way.
And the schools that you coached at?
Well, I was here in the 80s at Virginia Union.
Right, I remember.
I left here and went to Hampton for 16 years.
Right.
Then, of course, the last five I was at Florida A&M.
Okay.
But my initial college coaching started at Eastern Illinois, where we won a national championship in Division II in 1978.
Okay.
And just met a lot of great people over the years. That's one great thing about athletics. You know, you just get a chance to meet so many great people, and administrators, of course, coaches, and by no stretch, all the great student athletes that you have a chance to meet. And all we've done now is transition from coaching players to coaching coaches. And my good friend Craig Littlepage up at UVA, he defines AD as herding cats. and what he's simply saying is when you're coaching one sport, certainly the organization, the management is a little bit more tunnel. But with an AD responsibility, we have 15 sports over at VUU.
Mm-hmm.
And to manage and make sure that we are, you know, we've come in, we've done a SWOT analysis, kind of looked at the strength, the weaknesses, the opportunities, and the threats. And since that, we've kind of reconstructed the policy and procedure manual so that if I get hit upside the head coming in one morning and don't make it, it's in writing as
right.
to how we operate. And that, to me, is the first line of success, and that's organization. We've organized the whole program. We've looked at some leadership in different programs, and we've made changes to eight of our sports in terms of new leadership.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm really satisfied with the direction that we're going. Because when parents entrust their young people to our stead, it's a real honor, but a great challenge.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't have the luxury to not be at our best because, you know, we're leading young people. They need our best selves. And to do that, we got to be on the same accord. We have to understand day to day when those kids come to us as a freshman,
mm-hmm.
that after 4 or 5 years in our program, that there's a blueprint that has created an individual that is now ready to move out and be productive in our society. So we meet, we organize, we have different committees, and we meet administratively with our athletic staff to make sure that we are always evaluating how effective our program is. Do we see growth in all of our student athletes? Because we don't concern ourselves with being champions on game day. We want to be champions every day.
Mm-hmm.
We have to make sure that whatever they're doing on a daily basis is leading up to being a champion, first of all, person, secondly, student, thirdly, athlete. And it must be in that order. And we're happy to say that we feel good about the progress that's being made.
There seems to definitely be a change over at Virginia Union University. We have a couple of minutes before we go to break, but what I want to do is throw the first question, the second question here at Coach James. Coach James, you had a stellar year last year by some standards.
Thank you.
But I've heard you say that wasn't good enough. You were 7-3 last year. And a lot of people picked you guys to finish at the bottom. You came through there, got that team up, rough and ready, and you won 7 out of 10 games last year. Coach, we got about a minute and a half before we go to break. Coach, what was the key to your success last year?
The ability to be able to come in and buy into the vision of the AD and try to change the culture. Winning breeds winning. You said it pretty much when you introduced Coach Taylor. His philosophy of coming in and being able to make changes. Sometimes you got to, you know, change the whole system for the system to understand the true vision of where you want to go. So that was the greatest impact, I believe, initially. The second thing was changing the culture on campus and the feeling toward the football program.
Mm-hmm.
And what ended up happening is a group of young men enjoyed and loved Virginia Union football, and they were able to turn it around from 3-7 to 7-3.
Well, I can tell you, you've got a big bullseye on your back this year from the CIAA.
They have you, Virginia State, Virginia Union, and Fayetteville State as the four top teams in the CIAA. And I'm not saying this because you all are in here. I have a friend that can call you from Northern Virginia. I was telling him back 2 or 3 months ago, I don't care who you look at in the CIAA in 2015, you better keep your eye on Virginia Union. I'm going to tell you, I've seen you guys work out up there. I've seen your players off time running, throwing balls. Somebody was up at the ball on the field yesterday, and I saw them up there. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a break. We're going to come back. I have the athletic director from Virginia Union, Coach Taylor, and I have the head football coach, Coach Mark James, from Virginia Union University. We're going to go to a four-minute break. When we come back, I got one or two more small questions I want to ask, and then I'm going to open up the calls. I know it's early in the show, but, you know, you're always early on the Jack Gravely Show. Stay with me. We'll be right back. Ladies and gentlemen, you're on the Jack Gravely Show. Ryan is running my board this morning, my main man, Mr. Jim Juno, the SID, Sports Information Director from Virginia Union, is in the house. Coach Mark James is in the house, and Athletic Director Joe Taylor is in the house. Yes, I have an agenda. We're going to talk about other issues. The first hour on the Jack Gravely Show this morning, we're talking CIAA football in the person of Virginia Union University. I was talking to Coach James. Coach James, you know, you have a big bullseye. People expect a lot out of what you have. You have some guys coming back. I understand you got 3 or 4 quarterbacks in the fold over there, and there's whispers around town that you picked up a quarterback from VUU or somewhere, a young quarterback you didn't expect, and we understand that you did something else that's never been done at Virginia Union University. You hired a full-time quarterback coach over at Virginia Union. So, Coach James, you didn't say much at the media day from CIAA, but a lot of people say that you are coaching like a fox over at Union. What do you have to say about that?
Well, the first thing I want to address is the bullseye.
Okay.
You know, a wise man told me before that if your expectations are high yourself, you never worry about the concerns of what people are worrying about you. So, you know, when it comes to our competition, we're our own competition. We will be as good as our work puts in to make us out to be. So we're just going to apply the same work ethic, and obviously what we did last year was not enough to be able to get it done, so we're going to work a little bit harder, work a little bit smarter, and make some corrections.
What is your offensive philosophy and what is your defensive philosophy?
Offensive philosophy is very simple. Get the ball in the hands of the best player. Defensive philosophy, as long as we stop them, they can't win.
See what y'all told me? Y'all told me you can't tell me, Mike. Y'all were right, man. I like that. What does your quarterback look like this year? You got to have a battle for that position over there?
Yeah, definitely is going to be an interesting situation. You know that we're returning Shaheen Dowdy, who was a 2-year starter on our team. And we've got Dane James, who's my son, who's also going to give some depth and experience, who actually played at FAMU with Coach Taylor. And we've got a couple guys coming in, a young guy coming in, and we believe that through that quarterback competition that we should be able to forge, you know, the leadership that we need.
When does camp start?
It starts September 4th. August the 4th, our kids come in.
That's
and
next
check
week?
In. Absolutely, sir.
2-a-days?
Not 2-a-days, no, sir.
Okay.
We'll start officially on the 7th.
A.D. Taylor, college football is expensive today. How does a Division II school make the ends meet, and what in your leadership is important to make those ends meet as an AD at Virginia Union?
Jack, that's a great question, and I often say to all of our coaches that if you really worth your salt, you have to understand that it's about fundraising. There's no way. Dr. Perkins is doing a great job over at Virginia Union. His main concern is the core, which is education.
Mm-hmm.
If we are worth our salt, we should not have to go over to the president's office, knock on his door for any of our needs. Fundamental needs, yes, but we have to understand that we are a valuable commodity in this community. Athletics, to me, is the front porch to everybody's house. And if the front porch doesn't look right, they normally won't go in.
Right.
So we have to understand that every time, see, we don't like to spend money. We have to invest money. Investing meaning that first year, of course, we wanted to get the fundamental organization in place. Mm-hmm. But this year, we've been out trying to get partners to come in with us, eateries, because people who are interested in sports, there's three areas you got to be concerned with in terms of partnering and fundraising. Eateries is the first thing, because people going to eat when they come out the game.
Okay, exactly.
So we've gone out and given PowerPoints to different eateries. The next one is hotels, because people travel.
Mm-hmm.
And when they come into town, they need places to stay. It's important that hotels understand that we are bringing business. So in return, we need to get some revenue from them.
Mm-hmm.
And then transportation is the other area. So again, you have to, and I've looked at all of these programs throughout the country that are successful. Not only are they self-sufficient, but they also, in a lot of cases, give money to the academic side.
Mm-hmm.
We are really putting a fast forward on trying to go out and just get partnership, get people to buy into our athletic department, because the young people are doing a great job, and they deserve support. And alumni need to step up more. It's time out for fish dinners and raffles. You know, we're talking about putting on real, like the Burning Sands is putting on a golf tournament this coming Monday.
Mm-hmm.
Those are the kinds of events, and they are just as you said, and I appreciate you saying that. Loyalty to your alma mater, I love it.
Mm-hmm.
It's admirable. We just need to have more people that's loyal to their universities, because wherever they are, the platform started when they were in that mm-hmm. four-year mm-hmm. institution. So how dare you not give back to the place that promoted and allowed you to springboard into a successful career? So we're trying to appeal to alumni to give back. There are people coming behind you, and you can help.
You all are playing four home games this year. We have a poster on the wall here at WLEE, Virginia Union Panthers. They're starting out September 5 with Brevard College, and they're playing Garnet Webb, they're playing St. Hall. Your out-of-conference schedule is going to be a little demanding this year, and we're going to get to that, Coach James. Just hold on 1 minute. But, Coach Taylor, if individuals want to purchase tickets, season tickets, or game-by-game tickets, where can they come? Where can they call? How can they get a ticket to go to the games?
Well, great, great. And C.D. King is our business office. They can go from 8 to 5 each day. And we're about to get our website up so that they can also order
online.
Online.
Mm-hmm.
Or they can stop by the football or the athletic office to pick up tickets. And it's $60. For a season pass.
Bargain.
A bargain. So $70, if you don't have mm-hmm. a season
right.
Pass, plus the parking.
Right.
So again, it's a great bargain, and even if you don't plan to come every game, which I'm sure you plan to, but we can give the tickets to the neighborhood kids who wouldn't otherwise have an opportunity to come and see a college game. And we'll want that as much as we can, because we want the community to get involved. And these kids that come on our campus so that they see it's not a monster. Mm-hmm. You don't have to be anybody special. Just be somebody who want to do the best they can with their life. So season passes, like I said, September 5th. And it's going to, every other year, last year we had 6 home games, 4 away. Mm-hmm. This year is 4 home and 6 away.
Okay.
So it kind of rotates on the year. But that is a great deal, and please, you do not want to miss a game this year.
Well, I can tell you, Coach James, you're playing Brevard College from out in the southwestern part of North Carolina. You're playing Garnet Webb, and you're playing St. All, and all those three games count as out-of-conference games. That's going to be a little demanding schedule. You've never played Brevard before, have you? I don't think so.
No, I haven't, no.
What do you expect from them? Anything you know about them that you can share with us?
Yeah, they're a very tough team, as in, you know, they had over 3,700 yards rushing last year. So we know right there we're going to be able to test our defense to see what our defense will be able to do against a run-dominated team.
And this game is going to be in Richmond or Brevard, North Carolina?
It'll be right there on Hubby Field.
On Hubby Field.
Yes, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, Brevard. And Brevard just started their football program
last 20, 25 years or something like
absolutely,
that. They're
absolutely.
A young program.
Absolutely.
And Virginia Union is certainly a legendary program. It's about 9:30. We're going to go to a break. And I guarantee you, when I come back, I will open the phones up for your calls and questions about tickets, about games. And you can tiptoe on the brain of Coach Taylor and Coach James from Virginia Union University. Stay with us on the Jack Gravely Show. Ladies and gentlemen, you're back with me on the Jack Gravely Show, coming to you from WLEE News Talk 980. The phone lines are open if you want to call in and address a question to the athletic director, Joe Taylor at Virginia Union University. The phone lines are open. If you want to talk to Coach James, the phone lines are open, or if you want to ask a combination question to either of them. My telephone number is 788-0990, 788-0990. My toll-free number is 877-953-3990. I tell you what, yesterday I gave away two season passes. I've just been informed that we have some additional season passes. The third caller that called me, I will give you a free pass to the Virginia Union football season. It includes parking and one seat.
No, sir, I'm sorry.
The third caller will get the pass.
Thanks for calling, Jack Gravely.
And we're going to have a couple more to give away on the Jack Gravely Show this morning with the athletic director and the head football coach in. And when he gets the caller, Ryan is going to give me a thumbs up. We got it.
Yeah.
Third caller already called in. Pass is going. What happens now? Ryan will write your name on an envelope, write your telephone number. Your ticket will be left at the front office. You can come to WLEE 308 West Broad Street, pick up your free pass to the Virginia Union football season, 308 West Broad Street, from 9 to 5. Now, hold on. If you don't show up, you pick up that pass,
is easiest to reach you.
We're going to give it to someone else.
Call you.
All right?
Mm-hmm.
Let that marinate just for a minute. If you don't show up, we're going to give it away.
And when you come
because
in,
the phone lines are ringing on the passing, but we got a free winner here this morning. That's a great idea. PR.
And
Coach Taylor, as AD, not only are you a football
ID,
man, not only are you a student man, a class man, but you are also a PR man. You have to PR, public relation, that organization, which is a business. Virginia Union Football is a business.
Yes. It is a fact that one of the first things that took place
when
we arrived, we took the windscreen down off of the surround hubby because it was just a burgundy piece of cloth. But we put a windscreen that gives our website so that when people are riding up and down Brook Road and Lombardi, they look over, they see the website, and we're driving them to the website.
Exactly.
And when they come to the website, we always have human interest stories.
Thank you.
On the outstanding accomplishments of our student athletes, of our coaches, of the university. And, you know, you got a jawbone for yourself. It's no good for us to only be excited, but we are, again, very valuable in this community, and we are not an option, but to me, we are the reason people should be excited about what's going on, because that's what our kids need to see.
Coach James, as a coach, how long are your average daily practice during season?
Hour and a half.
What about preseason?
Hour and a half. Consistency.
Coach James, you got to get a lot in an hour and a half.
We get it in and get it out.
How many other coaches do you have on staff with you?
We have seven other coaches on staff.
And you're the head coach, and you all break it down in segments for position coaches and that kind of stuff?
Coordinate.
And all
correct.
Like that?
Yes, sir.
And your practice is on Hubby Field?
Absolutely.
Are your practices generally open to the public?
As long as you want to wake up at 5:30 in the morning.
You all practice in the morning.
You got to get in before the owls get home.
5:30 in the morning.
Absolutely, sir.
One moment.
From 5:30 to what? 8?
We go right below 8 o'clock. Yes, sir.
And then the kids go shower and get to class.
Absolutely. When we came on campus, we wanted to change the culture also with our academics. So what we decided to do was practice in the morning so that the kids would have the remainder of the day for themselves and their academics.
Wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, you heard that you got young son, young niece, nephew, not niece. You know, I don't know. understand college, you might be getting up 5 o'clock in the morning to go football practice.